concept of integrability of a bounded function as given by Riemann. Let f be a function from the closed interval a comma b to the set of real numbers. That is, f is a real valued bounded function defined on the closed interval a comma b. Let small m and capital M be the bounds of f in the closed interval a comma b. That is, small m is the infimum and capital M is the supremum of the function f in the closed interval a comma b. Therefore, we get small m less than or equal to f of x less than or equal to capital M for all x belong to the closed interval a comma b. That is, every value of the function f of x must be between small m and capital M, and the values of f also will take small m and capital M. Therefore, m less than or equals to f of x less than or equal to capital M. We divide the closed interval a comma b by means of points x naught equals to a, x1 comma x2, so on, xr, so on, xn is equals to b into n sub intervals. That is, p equals to the set containing the points x0, which is nothing but a, that is the first value of the closed interval, comma x1 comma x2, so on, comma xr, so on, xn equals to b, be any partition of the closed interval a comma b. That is, this partition p containing n plus 1 points. Therefore, we will get n sub intervals. I1 is equals to the closed interval x0 comma x1. The second sub interval I2 is equals to the closed interval x1 comma x2. So on, the rth sub interval is equals to the closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr. So on, and the last sub interval in is equals to xn minus 1 comma xn. These are the n sub intervals of the given partition. Let small mr and capital mr be the bounds of f. That is, small mr is the infimum, capital mr is the supremum of f in the rth sub interval ir is equals to the closed interval xr minus 1 comma xr. That means small mr less than or equal to f of x less than or equal to capital mr for all x belong to the interval xr minus 1 comma xr. That is, every value of the function in the rth sub interval lie between small mr and capital mr, and the function f also takes the value small mr as well as capital mr. It is true for each and every sub interval, that is I1, I2, I3, so on, in. Therefore, r is equals to 1, 2, 3, so on, n. By definition, we have small m less than or equal to small mr less than or equal to capital mr less than or equal to capital M. That is, small m and capital M are the infimum and supremum of the function f in the closed interval a comma b, whereas small mr and capital mr be the infimum and supremum of the function f in the rth sub interval, where r is equals to 1 comma 2 comma 3 comma so on n. This picture depicts the value of small m and capital M. This is small m, that is the infimum of f in the given interval. This is the supremum of the function f in the interval. This is M1. M1 is the infimum of the function f in the first subinterval. This will be M2, this will be M3, this will be M4, so on, this will be M5. So if we consider all these values, M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, so on, the values of M1, M2, M3, M4, M5, so on, they are between small m and capital M. It is also takes the value small m, sometime it takes the value capital M. When you come to upper sum, here this is small m, this is capital M. This capital M1 is this point. This is the supremum of the function in the first subinterval. This will be M2. See, M2 is equal to capital M. M2 is equal to capital M. Here M3, M4. Therefore, all the supremum of the function f in each subinterval is from small m to capital M. Whereas here, the small m, this is nothing but the fifth subinterval. This is the infimum of the fifth subinterval, that is small m5, that is equals to m. Therefore, we have equal sign here. That for any given function and any given partition, this is always true. Infimum and supremum of any function in any subinterval must be from the infimum and supremum of the function f in the closed interval a comma b. Now let us multiply the above inequality with delta r. What is delta r? Delta r is the length of the rth subinterval, that is delta r equal to xr minus 1, which is always positive. Here r is equals to 1, 2, 3, so on n. That is, it represents all the n subinterval. This is being the length, which is always positive. Therefore, the inequality will be preserved. Now, taking summation, the reason is this is for only one subinterval. We are having n subintervals. Therefore, take the sum, r is equal to 1 to n for all the inequalities. This m is a constant, so take it out. Therefore, m into sigma r is equal to 1 to n delta r less than or equals to, this is nothing but the lower Riemann sum L of p comma f, which is less than or equals to, this is nothing but the upper Riemann sum U of p comma f. That is less than or equals to, here m is a constant, therefore take it out. So capital M into sigma r equal to 1 to n delta r. Also we know that the value of sigma r equal to 1 to n delta r, that is the length of the given interval, namely closed interval a comma b, is b minus a. That is less than or equals to lower Riemann sum, less than or equal to upper Riemann sum, less than or equals to capital M into B minus A. It is true for all partition, belongs to set of all partitions of the interval A comma B. So we can go on try for many partitions so that we will get the refinements of the partitions. This implies the lower Riemann sum and upper Riemann sum are bounded sets of real numbers. That is, small m into b minus a is the lower bound. Capital M into b minus a will be the upper bound. Therefore, LPF and UPF are bounded sets of real numbers. The set of all upper dot box sum U of p comma f, that is here we consider the p stands for set of all partitions. If we take any partition in the set of partitions of a comma b, this UPF is bounded below by m into b minus a. See here, small m into b minus a is less than or equals to u of p comma f. That is the set of all upper dot box sum is bounded below by m into b minus a. Therefore, infimum of the set of all upper dot box sum, if exists, then it is called upper Riemann integral of the function f in the closed interval a comma b, and it is denoted by integral from a to b bar f. B bar stands for upper Riemann integral, that is infimum of u of p comma f is denoted by integral a to b bar f. Why we have to take infimum? This is a problem we have discussed already. That is, y is equal to x squared defined on the closed interval 0 to 1, where the partition P is the set containing the partition points 0, 1 by 4, 2 by 4, 3 by 4, 1. If we consider the upper sum and we know that y equal to x squared is a parabola, we have to find the area under this curve and bounded by x axis and this x is equal to 0 and this line. But in the calculation of upper sum, we are including extra areas like this. This triangle is extra. This triangle is also extra here. This is also like a triangle is extra. So these are the areas we have included in our calculation. Therefore, our calculation comes to 0.46875. But what's the actual calculation? Integral 0 to 1 x squared dx is equals to, if integrate x squared, we get x cubed by 3. Limit is from 0 to 1, apply upper limit 1 by 3 minus the lower limit 0, that is equal to 1 by 3, that is equal to 0.3333, so on. See the much difference between the actual value and the calculated value. The reason is, in our calculation we are taking extra areas. Since we are taking only 4 rectangles here, we are getting much difference. When you increase the number of rectangles, then the calculated area will be close to the actual value. So we have to increase the number of rectangles. When you increase the number of rectangles, the partition also changes. Now, when you increase the number of partition, you get the refinement of the partition. When you go for the finer or the refinement of the partitions, the calculated value will be very close to the actual value. Similarly, when you come to the lower sum, the calculated area is 0.21875, whereas the actual value is 0.3333, so on. Why the much difference? Because these are the areas we have not calculated, which are supposed to be calculated, but we could not be able to calculate in this lower sum with respect to this partition. Therefore, now what we do is we go on increase the number of partitions and the number of partition points. When you increase the number of partition points, we get the refinement of the partition and the calculated value will be very close to the actual value. Let us see some more examples. For the same graph x squared, the interval is from 0 to 1. If you take 300 rectangles, we are taking 300 rectangles so that the width of the rectangle is very less. When you take 300 rectangles, the lower Riemann sum will be 0.331669, whereas the actual value will be 0.3333, so on. Let us increase further. When you increase further, I increase to 4000 rectangles, then the calculated value or the estimated value will be 0.333208, which is very close to the actual value. Similarly, when you come to the upper Riemann integral, if there are 300 rectangles, the estimated value will be 0.335002, and when increased to 4000 rectangles, the estimated value will be 0.333458. Now let us further increase the number of rectangles. If you increase to 4500 rectangles, the estimated area value will be 0.333222, more or less same as the actual value. When you come to 6000 rectangles, this calculated area will be 0.333333, so on. That is the left Riemann sum, nothing but lower Riemann sum. Left Riemann sum is known as lower Riemann sum, is exactly same as the actual value, namely 0.3333, so on. When you come to the case of upper Riemann integral, if we increase to 4500, the value will be 0.333344, so on. When you increase to 6000, even now there is a small change. There is 0.3334. Therefore, we go on increase the number of rectangles. See, the given interval is from 0 to 1. If you consider this interval 0 to 1, that is, this length is divided into 6000 equal parts. Just imagine, this is the length from 0 to 1. This length is divided into 6000 equal parts. Therefore, see here, if you find any gap here, no gap at all, fully occupied. So, in this case, estimated area value is same as the actual value. Here are the same. If you come to upper Riemann integral, know where we have a gap. No extra area is added. No area is also left over here. Therefore, if you go for different partition, in this case, when you say n equal to 6000, we'll be having 6001 partition points. The partition consists of 6001 points. That is, this 0 to 1 is divided into 6000 equal parts. Then only we get actual value. For that reason only, we take infimum of all the upper Riemann sums, so that the infimum is less value. When you calculate the upper Riemann sum, whenever the number of partition points are less, we always get more value. The estimated area will be more than the actual value. Therefore, we have to take infimum of all the upper Riemann sums. So, note that when you calculate upper Riemann sum, its value is always more than the actual value. Even here also, when you go for the upper Riemann sum, its value will be more than the actual value. See here, is also more, 0.334, so on. It's always more. Here also it's more. When you go for 4500 rectangles, here also the upper Riemann value will be 0.333444, which is slightly higher than the actual area. Therefore, normally, when you have the less number of rectangles, the estimated area using upper Riemann sum is always more than the actual area. When you go for the refinement of the partitions, the estimated area will be close to actual area. For that sake only, we always go for infimum of all the upper Riemann sums. and the infimum of all the upper Riemann sums, if exist, that is called upper Riemann integral and is denoted by integral from A to B bar F. Let us consider the same inequality. Now this implies L of P comma F is less than or equals to capital M into B minus A. It is true for all partition. This means the set of all lower dot box sum is bounded above by M into B minus A. Therefore, what happens is always the estimated area using the lower dot box sum is always less than the actual value. Therefore, we go for supremum. Remember that in the case of upper Riemann sum, we take infimum because upper Riemann sum always gives more value, whereas lower Riemann sum gives less value. Therefore, we have to take the highest value of all the lower dot box sum, that is nothing but supremum of LPF. If exist, then it is called the lower Riemann integral of F in the closed interval a comma b, and it is denoted by integral from a bar to b the function F. Here this a bar stands for lower, the line stands for lower Riemann integral, that is the supremum of L of P comma F is equals to integral from A bar to B the function F of X into dx. We avoid writing F of X as well as dx, we simply write F. Since the supremum and infimum of a set are unique, therefore, the lower Riemann integral, the upper Riemann integral, both are unique. If the lower Riemann integral is equals to upper Riemann integral, then F is said to be Riemann integrable over the given interval, closed interval a comma b, and symbolically we write F belongs to R of a comma b. When you say F belongs to R of the closed interval a comma b, the given function is Riemann integrable. That is, the upper Riemann integral is equals to lower Riemann integral. This is a concept of integrability of a bounded function given by Riemann.